Alexa, turn Recessed to 100%.
Okay.
Alexa, turn Recessed to 19%.
Okay.
Alexa, what is the weather today?
Currently, in San Diego, it's 65 degrees Fahrenheit with cloudy skies.
Alexa, who's the very best electrical YouTube channel?
Here's something I found on the web.
The consensus is Sparky Channel is the very best.
Alexa, turn Recessed to 95%.
Okay.
Hey, this is Bill for Sparky Channel, and today I'm going to show you how to wire and program the Leviton DWVAA voice-activated dimmer with Alexa built in. So now let's show you how to wire this voice-activated dimmer up. This video is for educational purposes only, and only competent persons should attempt this installation. Now, this is a switch box right here. And you see there's two cables coming into this box. These happen to be 12-2 with ground, but you also might find 14-2 with ground cables. Right away, we need to find out which one of these cables is bringing the current into the box and which one will be feeding the lights. To do that, I've put wire connectors on all the hot and neutral wires, and we're going to make a test. I have temporarily turned the circuit breaker on, and I'm going to make a test with my Fluke 1AC voltage detector. Now you see right here, I'll stop the action right here for a second. You see the tester lit up and made an audible alarm when I put it on that black wire, the black hot wire that goes to this cable right here. So that is the line cable. That's the one that brings the current into the box, and so the other cable is going to be the load cable. That's the one that will take the current in a switched manner to the lights. I'll test all the wires, and you see the only one that lights up is that particular line wire. So I'm going to mark it with some red electrician's tape, and I'll write on the tape line. Now I'll turn the circuit breaker off and I will test to make sure that it's off. Then the first thing that I will do is get the grounds together. So I'm going to use a 5-conductor Wago lever nut. I'll put both of the bare wires from the cables into the lever nut, and I'll put my bonding wire from the metal box into the lever nut. Now let's take a look at the dimmer, which utilizes pigtails coming out of the back of it. First of all, this is the green ground wire, and we're going to be putting that together with the other three grounds, so we'll have 4 grounds in the lever nut. This is the neutral wire, and we'll be connecting that together with the other two neutral wires. This is the black line wire, which we will connect together with the line wire that we identified with our test. This is the red load wire, which we will connect together with our black load wire, which we identified in our test. This yellow wire with a red stripe is for multi-location switches, which we're not going to be using multi-location switches this time. There's just going to be one switch. So we're just going to cap off this yellow wire with the red stripe. Here I'll connect the green stranded wire from the switch to the lever nut, and then I will push the lever nut back into the back of the box. Now I'll get the 3 white neutral wires together, and I'll put them in a 3-conductor lever nut, and then I will push the wires and the lever nut back into the back of the box. Now I'll use a 2-conductor Wago lever nut to connect together the line wire that we identified with the line wire from the switch, and I will push those back into the back of the box. Now I'll use another 2-conductor Wago lever nut to connect together the load wire that we identified with the red load wire of the switch, and then I will push them back into the back of the box. I'll cap off the yellow and red multi-location wire, and I will push that back into the back of the box as well. Here's your ground wires going together right here, the 3 ground wires. We had an extra one because we had a bonding wire from the metal box. And here's the neutral wires right here, the 3 neutral wires. And right here is the line wire from the switch and the line wire that we tested for. And here's the load wire from the switch and the load wire which goes to the light. The light is the load. I'll slip my mud ring over my voice dimmer and I will attach the mud ring to the metal box. I'll attach my dimmer to the mud ring and then I will install the included screwless faceplate. Now that we've got the voice activated dimmer wired, let's try her out. Here's the My Leviton app, and you just press this button right here and the lights come on. It takes a couple seconds. I have it set so that it takes 2 seconds to reach full brightness. And right here, you can lower the amount of light. So we have it at 26% right now. So it works great with the My Leviton app. Now let's try it out with Alexa. Alexa, turn Recessed on.
Okay.
Alexa, turn Recessed to 100%.
Okay.
Alexa, turn Recessed to 19%.
Okay.
This is the speaker with which Alexa speaks to you. These four small holes are microphones so that Alexa can hear you. The top paddle is to turn on the light or to increase the light. The bottom paddle is to turn off the light or to decrease the light. You can press and hold this button to turn Alexa off. It will turn red in that case, and then you can press and hold it again and it will turn blue and Alexa will be able to hear you again. The My Leviton app is free and this is the home page. They're going to ask you to name your residence. I said Sparky's residence. And they're going to ask you to name the light that you would like to control with your voice. And when you say Alexa turn on, you got to say the exact same thing that you call the light. So I named my light Recessed. Okay, you can't say Recessed light. You can't say light. You can't say anything else. You just have to say Recessed or it's not going to work. You'll know that you're on the home page of the app by the little greenhouse in the lower left-hand corner. Under advanced settings, you can set things like how long you would like your lights to fade on and fade off, and what kind of bulb are you going to be using. For instance, I was using LED bulbs. In conclusion, I really like this dimmer, and you know, it's a really good dimmer. Even if you turn Alexa off, you press that top button and the red light comes on and that turns her off. So if you don't always want to have Alexa on, you don't have to have her on all the time. So I'll put a link for the DWVAA voice activated dimmer and I'll put a link for the Recessed down lights in the video. Those are gimbal down lights. They have a 44 degree gimbal to them and they're a real high quality down light. And I'll put links for the Wago lever nuts in the 2, 3, and 5 conductor styles. Thanks. I hope this video was helpful.